shoot him. What up, y'all, and welcome back to another one.
Oh, Fred, he just got out of the bath. Look at him. He's looking sharp, isn't he? Oh, yeah, Fred. That's a good-looking boy right there.
Well, today Fred can't go, though. We're going on a crow hunt today, y'all. Y'all have been requesting me to get out and do another crow hunt since the last one. And Jordan, he called me yesterday. He's like, dude, we need to crow hunt. And I'm like, I know. The season's almost over. We need to get after it. That's what we're doing today. Two-man little crow hunt.
What are you doing out here? It's cold, man.
He always gets shy for the camera.
Come here, Bubba. It's cold. You need your hoodie on. Tell everybody hi.
Hi.
Just tell them your name.
Bodie.
Your name's Bodie? Yeah. Are you going to be a duck hunter too?
Yeah.
You is? Well, do you want to go hunting? You do?
We'll go hunting soon. He's still a little. He's still only 2.5 going on 3 here. But when he gets a little bit bigger, we'll be going. Won't we, Bubba?
Yeah.
So what we're going to do, this whole field, y'all, is chocked with crows. There's probably, my guess, 50 to 70 total, what we've been able to see. So we're going to walk this tree row all the way down, and then that one out there, that long one, we're going to try to get halfway out there in this quarter section. Set up, get all ready, get hunkered down, and then flip on the e-collars. We brought 2 e-collars. We're going to throw a lot of noise at them today. We brought some more decoys. Show them your decoys. Look at that. He took some regular old full bodies like my old ones and he flocked them himself. And he wants to help me flock mine. If y'all want to see that video, drop a comment down below. Let me know. Let Jordan know.
Yeah, I'm more than happy to do it.
He offered. I've never done it. A ton of you have requested some flocking videos. So if you want to see us flock some crows, flock some of my dive bomb silhouettes, the non-flocked ones, do some of them, let me know down below.
Sitting spot. Got a little evergreen in front of me here. I'm going to sit in the shadow of this tree.
Jordan's going to sit in the shadow of this tree. We're going to try to find him a little evergreen to shove in front of him as well. One thing I've learned about crow hunting, you have to be hid and you cannot move. I meant to grab my panel blind. I'm kind of glad I didn't, because that means I would have had to carry it a quarter mile, half mile here. Your boy's fat, you know. I'm getting old out here, y'all. But it's gonna be the operation for the hides. Let's set these decoys.
Well, we're all set up. Grabbing the e-collar here. Oh, I'm ready to go. Ha ha ha. Check it out. It looks good. Jordan brought, what, 3? 3 more full bodies? We've got a family group out there. They should be coming this way. We got it bunched up here, 2 dozen. Oh, this is awesome. We're gonna put both e-collars out. Oh yeah, boys. This is, might get wild. There's a bunch of crows. So, I'm gonna dig me just a small hole. Put this e-collar down in there. Bury it up a little bit. As good as I can. Get some more brush. Like so. There we go. Oh, we're looking good. Ha ha ha. I can guarantee if we can get some actual dead ones in here as decoys, dude, it's money.
I'm looking forward to it.
Let's get sat down and going here. Man, your shadow isn't as thick as mine. That's the bad deal. Yep. Say, man, you're gonna stick out. That's yeah, we need, yeah, before we fire up here, let's get a big evergreen in front of you. The ticket right here, dude. Get a branch like this. Look, poke it in the ground and stand the evergreens up against it. This really shades you on this side. Put another, here you go. Put one right here. There you go. Stand it up against that. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. There we're, now we're working. Now we're working, boys. I don't know, I'm trying to cast a shadow on you. So this is what we got going, guys. Little homemade blind action. Took some limbs, stuck them in the ground, took some evergreens. Trying to get, I'm naturally got a decent blind here. Trying to make the same for old Jordan.
It just turned into a bushcraft video. Right
here. It did, didn't it? What are you rocking today?
Ooh.
Black cowed, 3-inch double B.
Ooh.
I like them.
Hammers.
They work good on honkers. I don't know why they wouldn't work on crows.
Exactly. You guys don't know who Jordan is. You obviously are new to the channel. Jordan has his own YouTube channel, Jordan's Harvest. Go on over there, check him out. He's doing awesome. This is what I'm doing today though. Got the old Retay 3.5 and I am rocking the Black Cloud 3.5 inch BB. Yeah, I know, it's way overkill, but it's the only thing that I have just been able to plow the crows completely over and not just feather them, and they keep flying away from me. So here we go. I'm gonna turn her on here. Come on now, where are you at? Where's the crow selection? That's mine, isn't it? Okay, go ahead. Oh, this is gonna sound amazing. We got, remember, we can't move whatever we do. Dude, two collars sound awesome. It gives it every angle of the dangle. Oh, we might be onto something here, Jordan.
Hey, we'll find out here in a minute.
Yeah, we're gonna find out. We gotta be ready to spray though. I hope they give it up, man. Oh, that last video, they just cruise on in here, feet down just to doing it. And I hope we're not late. I hope we can shoot some here. If you guys like these videos here, me and Jordan getting after them like this, smash the thumbs up button, first of all. And if you have any video recommendations that you want us to do together, anything like this, pest control, pigeons, crows, starlings, sparrows, who knows, drop a comment down below, let us know.
Nothing coming at the time, man. There's a lot of waterfowl migrating today. Yeah, a lot. We've been seeing lines just up in the stratosphere, going north. So all you South Dakota snow goose hunters, Nebraska, they are coming your way in a hurry. But I think one thing, we're gonna spread this out. We can make it bigger, I believe. So we're gonna spread some decoys out. I don't know where all the crows, no, look, they're all down in that corner. They're all about 400, 300 yards down from us. But we're gonna spread this out. We're gonna make it a little bigger. I believe that they'll see it before they hear it. So that's why I wanna make it bigger and try it. We're gonna have to sit here for a couple hours, just like the last hunt I did. Gonna have to catch them once they get up off a feed. And while they're flying, they see it, they come, you call, you turn on the calls, bam. That's how it worked last time.
Oh, they're all right here. One up top. One up top. If he comes back right here, shoot his ass.
That is right in the sun. Oh, here he comes.
Get ready. Let him work. They're starting to show up.
Over your left shoulder.
Oh, yeah. Shoot him. Yeah! That boy dead.
We got him.
You there? Oh, look, Gerald's on the phone. Gerald called me. We were talking and I had to throw down the phone. Yeah, you are the good luck charm. Thank you, son.
Yeah.
There we go, one down. We're gonna be eating crow today, Gerald.
Oh, good grief.
Man, them 3.5 slap, dude.
Huh?
Why'd
you shoot your 410?
With the 410, I wouldn't be able to kill a crow with the 410.
Okay.
Hey, it'll smoke a snow goose, but the crow, man, they're tough.
Well, there we go. First bird down. Man, we were not ready. They started flying. What, 10 of them showed up? 5 of them? We better hurry up.
Oh, he's way out here though. Man, it took us 3 or 4 shots to hit him. There we go.
Look at that big old dude.
There we are. First bird down. Let's get back and get hit. If you guys are liking the video, you know what to do. Smash that thumbs up button for Jordan and I. Woo, this is fun. It's a success! There we go. We got a bird in the decoys. Gerald, thanks man, you are the good luck charm.
Dude, yes! Success! Success! All right, how are we gonna cook this crow?
With heat. That's as far as I've gotten.
I ate crow last year, and you guys have been asking me to do it again. We're gonna do it. Well, we got one down, we gotta do it now. Uh-oh, what'd you bust out?
Spice of jerky.
Half. Here, flip it. Hold on.
Oh.
Half. What does half mean, Jordan?
Half means it's half the normal heat that I put in my first batch.
Yep.
And it still makes your nose run, so.
Yes. So full, the nickname for full flavor is Zilla Killa. If y'all know who Matt Zilla is, the photographer that is always with us hunting. He about died one day eating full. That man, that boy there. This stuff here, what is that, goose today?
Mm-hmm.
Goose. I believe goose is even better than the, oh God, he. You catch a seed, bud?
There's something, yeah.
Garden. They're hot. Hot. If y'all like hot stuff, this would be the jerky for you. It's Jordan's, his own personal jerky. Yeah. We should give a bag away. Want to give a I'm bag down. A half away?
Sure.
I'll mail it to him.
Yeah, I'm down. I got an extra bag.
So how about this? I'll make y'all a deal. I asked y'all before to please comment on what y'all wanted Jordan and I to do. What videos you wanted Jordan and I to do. What you wanted to see us make for y'all.
Because we're happy to do it.
Yeah.
We're happy.
So, drop a, like I said, just drop a comment down below. Whoever comes up with the best video idea that we end up doing, that I end up picking, we'll send you a bag of the half hot, which is still extremely hot. I will warn you, whoever wins, just know, just don't go tearing into it. Try it out before you just go filling your belly with the whole bag, because it's very, very good. So drop a comment down below. Let us know what you want us to do, please. Well, we've heard a couple, but we haven't seen hardly anything. It's really shut down. We got one go. Darn it. It's, what's it at? 11, 11:15?
Something like that.
But it's 11:15.
Yep, 11:14.
Good guess, Bob. Good guess. I think we're going to sit it out maybe another 15, 30 minutes at most. Hopefully. I'm just going off the last hunt I had. The last hunt, I sat till noon. I think I shot my last bird at 11:30, 11:45. But in the meantime, I'm going to have to get some of that hot jerky for a good luck here. Let me test how hot it actually is.
Well, depends on the piece you get.
I'm a big hot guy. I like hot, and I love Jordan's jerky. It's amazing. Oh, it does, like he said, it's all about the piece you get. One piece can be way hotter than the other.
But you can't put a whole lot of Carolina Reaper in there to make it even. So some of them you just get blessed a little bit extra.
But you all are like, oh wow, he uses Carolina Reaper. Oh, that's why it's hot.
Where at? Oh, I see him, I see him. Get way down.
They're landing up there.
Here we go. Oh, come on. Get over. Oh, here he comes. Get ready. He's on the deck. Shoot him. He's coming, he's coming, he's coming. Get ready, hide. Shoot him. What?
Yeah! Yeah!
Oh, he got hammered so
hard. Oh, we hammered both of them.
Crushed.
Oh! Tell me that isn't
that
glory.
Awesome.
Oh! See when they decoy really good, how awesome is it?
He wanted to land.
Yeah, both of them. So that was a 3.5, and he has Black Cloud 3-inch.
Yep.
And that other one stopped in the tree and kept coming after his mate died.
Yep.
Holy cow. You go get that one. I'll go get. Oh, we smashed them. They got nailed. I hope that I got that on shot cam. Woo! It's only been literally probably 3 to 4 minutes since I took the lucky jerky. The last clip.
Dude got plowed over. Not gonna lie, buddy.
Woo! We got three on the ground, boys.
Man, they got some hardcore toenails and feet.
Oh, dude, it's not over. They might be coming back to roost. Oh, yeah, boys. Oh, yeah, boys.
Well, we are here back at the house. Just got done cleaning the crows, and we're prepping them for lunch. Oh, yeah, we're prepping for lunch, that is. Look at old Jordan. You're just getting down. He said, Bob, do you have ginger? We scoured the cabinets. Didn't find any ginger. Everything's packed up. Like I've been saying, we're moving. We're moving. We're moving. We literally are limited on spices, dishes, forks, knives, you name it. But I didn't even have a tenderizer. It's packed up. But old Jordan, Bear Grylls himself, found a fork. He's over here tenderizing the crow.
I'm just taking out my anger issues. That's really all I'm doing.
Right? First thing he said, Bob, crow, and I've ate it. We both ate crow. It's not much different from starlings. It's tough. He was like, you have to tenderize it. You gotta take it from its tough, especially when we're gonna eat it right off the bat like this. We're not gonna soak it very long at all. Tenderize it.
Oh yeah.
Name of the game.
Absolutely. And the big, big benefit also, since you're punching all these holes into it, when you marinate it like we are, you get a lot better penetration of your flavors and stuff. Because honestly, crow tastes, there's a reason they call it eating crow. It's not fancy meat by any means, but you can make it better by punching holes into it, making it more tender, and you get better flavor.
He's a chef, I'm not. Dude, do not hit one of your fingers, dude. Oh God! Well, since we're going straight from the field, straight to the mouth, we're starting with soy sauce.
Soy and lemon juice. The reason I like to use these is they are acidic and they help break it down even more tender, and they're really bold flavors. So, you know, I like to be a little generous with that.
Since it's crow.
Since it's crow.
And then what's this here?
This here is some black pepper.
Just putting some pepper on in it.
And I like pepper, so I like to put pepper in about everything.
We got here.
We got paprika. Paprika is great with wild game. It's a bold flavor, but it just sort of tends to meld a lot of stuff together really well. So I really like to throw that into a lot of stuff. Let's set for at least 15 minutes, as long as we can.
Okay, we're gonna let her sit, like you said, 15 minutes, as long as we can.
As long as we can, 15 minutes minimum.
So the grill's warming up. We'll give her, I'll put her on low. We'll give her another 15 minutes here. What's it smell like?
It smells like I put soy sauce in it.
Well, we got the grill. This side's warmed up here. Slap them on there, dog. Slap them down. Bam. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
They actually look really nice.
Yeah, they do look pretty darn good. I'm interested.
As hard as they got hit, I'm surprised they weren't tore up more, actually.
Yeah, you're right. We like, plowed them over.
Smacked. I think out of those four, there were four or five different pellet holes. There's a couple sides that didn't have any.
You smell that? It
smells good, actually.
It smells like something's burning, but
smells good. Crow, burnt crow.
I haven't got to watch the shot cam footage. All I can say is I hope that I got it all, because when I watched them birds get hit, woof, they went boom. But we had a good marinade. We let them sit for what, 45 minutes? Ish. So tenderize them, marinate them, 45 minutes. Here we go. They're on the grill. We're going to cook them up. And I can already say that they're probably going to be a lot better tasting than when I cooked them. When I did it, it was like bare bones, you know? So big shout out to Jordan. If you haven't subscribed to Jordan's channel, tell him.
I mean, I'm a little channel, but I do the best I can though. So come on over and check me out.
Jordan's Harvest. I'll link him down in the description below. Go check him out. Oh, what a good looking dog. Sit. He's being a good boy. We've been getting back on the training, having him place in weird places. Here we go. We just let the old crow cool off. This is the finished product. And it doesn't smell too bad.
No. And if it's a little char, that's on purpose. I'm skeptical of undercooked crow. It scares me.
It should scare you because these things eat whatever they find. Roadkill, dead coyotes, anything they find. It's gross. All right, let's go. Let's go. Come on now.
How
come on.
I have to go first?
Well, you don't. I'm going with you. It feels decent. Oh, I'm scared of this stuff.
Hey, this can't be worse than a chicken nugget.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, right.
Dink it.
Bang. Ew.
It's not good. Not horrible. Trying to figure out if I like it better than this. Excuse me. Trying to figure out if I like it better than Starling or not.
It's a hair better than Starling.
I think it is better than Starling.
A hair. It's a hair better than Starling. If I can describe it, if you guys have never ate crow, the meat just doesn't taste right, to be quite honest. Now, if we were to let this marinate for days and do a bunch of work to it, sure, you can make anything taste how you want it after enough time. But we went from filled to mouth.
It's trying really hard to be good, though.
Ugh, it's hard, though.
Yeah, it's trying, though. Like, I can definitely tell. Another hour of marinade, it probably would have been a whole lot better.
If you would have definitely did, like, 24 hours of marinade, it would have been great, but...
Because the edges are really good.
The actual meat taste of crow, this fast from filled to food to mouth, and it's not good. It doesn't taste good on the tongue. Well, that's gonna wrap it up. I hope you guys enjoyed today's crow hunt. Little two-man crow hunt. It was epic. I have to say so myself. I had an absolute blast crow hunting. If you guys want to see me and Jordan get out and do some more crow hunts, again, for like the fourth or fifth time, you gotta let us know down in the comment section below. Subscribe if you haven't. Hit that little notification bell down there because it'll notify you when your boy uploads. But stick around for the lodge videos. The lodge videos, the new house. We're getting there. We're almost there, y'all. But until next time, peace. I've been getting laid back, baby. You should know that I don't need your criticism, pessimism. I've been keeping it on the DL. Got a girl that